What is up, guys? Jimmy or Chaos Silencer. Welcome to Walk and Talk Vlogs. It's Friday. It is vlog time. It looks like it's fixing to rain, so we're going to have to get this in quick. And before we get into the topic, I want to tell you guys about a new series on PTFO, a live show that is going to be airing Saturday night at 9 p.m. Central Standard Time tomorrow. It's called the PTFO Roundtable. And what we're going to do is we're going to let people vote on our Facebook fan page, and we're gonna bring in 6 commentators each show just to hang out, talk, maybe call some hookers, do some crazy stuff, and just get to know some commentators. It's a good chance for commentators to get, a lot of people want to get on PTFO, and the main show, obviously we only have one guest, so it's hard to get a lot of people. This one is different. It doesn't matter the size of your channel. It's gonna be really cool. All you have to do is go to the Facebook fan page of PTFO. Once the poll goes up, put yourself on there, or put the commentator on there you want us to invite, and we'll pick 6 of them tomorrow and they'll be on the show. Doesn't matter their size, just as long as they have a viewership and they make content on YouTube. So, should be a lot of fun. And today we're going to talk about, I'm already tired because I already did some walking. But anyway, I'm going to make it through it. Today we're going to talk about job interviews. I don't have my phone on me, but I got a message. A guy said he was fixing to go in for his first interview for a job, and he wanted some advice. And I can give some advice on this. I've interviewed hundreds of people. I've hired hundreds of people. Before I did YouTube, I was an area manager of area of operations, or director of operations type deal, and a general manager for numerous restaurants and retail businesses. So I think I can give you some advice. And it starts before you even go to the interview. It starts from the point you go in to turn in an application, or get an application, or turn in a resume. And 2 key things. This is something I always look for. One, that the person is dressed properly. I'm not saying that you have to, and remember, this isn't the interview. This is just you coming in to get an application or turn in a resume. And I'm not saying you have to come in a 3-piece suit and have some pimped out boots on and stuff like that, but you need to look presentable. You need to look like you took the effort to show them that this is important to you. And you come in, get the application, so on and so forth, fill it out. Because first impressions are key. And the second one, this may seem small to some people, but you already have a strike in your book with me if you come in to my place of business asking about a job, wanting an application, and then you ask me for a pen to fill out the application. All that tells me is you didn't think things through, you didn't come prepared, you knew you were going to fill out stuff, and you didn't bring your own pen. So you're already down one in my book. And you may say, well, Jimmy, that sounds super picky. Why would you be that way? It's just stuff I look at. If I'm going to go fill out an application or turn in a resume, and there's a chance that I have to fill out any documentation, I'm going to bring my own pen. I'm going to be ready. I'm not going to already put my fate in somebody else's hands to help me have the equipment that I need to fill out an application. That's just me. I don't know. But I promise you, a lot of people look for that too. So remember that. Now let's say you get the call back and you get an interview. Okay, you're nervous, obviously, especially if it's your first interview. Here's a few things that you can do. There's a deer. No, I thought I saw a deer. Here's a few things you can do to help you out in that interview. First of all, if it's a one-on-one, or even if it's one-on-two, make sure you make eye contact with the interviewer. Always make eye contact. Even though you're not used to that, always do it, because it shows that you're listening. It shows that you're in tune and sync to what they're saying. And I promise you, they'll appreciate it in the long run, because it also shows confidence. And confidence is a big issue when it comes to interviews. Do not go in there and feel like you, what's the word I'm looking for? Don't go in there being bashful or secluded or anything. You've got to breed confidence. You've got to show it, and show them that you want the job, and show them that you're confident in your abilities to do the job. Otherwise, they're going to find somebody else. They're looking for somebody that's confident. There's a squirrel. Anyway, make eye contact with the interviewer. Stay on point and focus on them. Also remember now, you're also interviewing them, because they're trying to sell you on the job that they have. Does it have proper benefits? Does it have the money you want? So on and so forth. There's a lot of different categories and things that you go into, but you can get to that at a later date. Next one is, make sure you're dressed appropriately. This isn't just going in to fill out an application. This is actually doing the interview. They want to talk to you about getting this job. So make sure you go in dressed properly. You may need a suit and tie. It depends on the industry you're in, but do not go in with some khaki shorts, flip-flops, and a polo shirt. Just don't. Or you might as well not even go to the interview. Second, be involved in the conversation. Be ready when they ask you a question. Be ready to ask it. And don't be afraid to ask your own questions back to them about their business. They like that. People like talking about their business. Nothing better for a boss than to boast on, well, we can offer you these benefits and this salary, and this is what blah, blah, blah can do for you for a vacation plan. All bosses love talking about the benefits of their company, so don't be afraid to ask. And second on this is, make sure when the interview's done, and I know this is another little thing, make sure you get up and you shake their hand. Tell them thank you for the interview process. You look forward to talking to them, or you look forward to hearing from them. Don't put a negative out there that, well, I hope you pick me, and if I do, I can't wait to talk to you. Put out a positive, like, you know you've already got the job. I look forward to hearing from you guys. I look forward to when you contact me back. It breeds confidence, and it makes them think, wow, this guy really wants this job. A couple other little things. Don't do anything negative or say anything negative. Don't get into drama issues when you're talking. Everything needs to be positive and reflecting a positive light on you, your traits, your abilities that you can bring to the table. And that's pretty much it. There's a lot more, but that should get you started. Just remember, be confident. I know you're going to be nervous. Everybody's nervous in an interview, but don't let them see that. They're expecting to see that, and if they don't see that and they see somebody that's confident and selling themselves for what they believe they can do, it's going to impress them. I promise. I promise you it's going to impress them. So that's it, guys. Walk and Talk Vlog's over. Be sure to rate and comment. Look for the roundtable video tomorrow for PTFO. And I'm out of here. It's fixing to rain. See? May not look dark there. Bye, guys.